Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to On Academy. So today we are going to discuss about Hilton Mayo, who is known as the father of human relation theory. So before that, just look into this classical theorist, behavioral theorist. So the classical theorist consists of Taylor, Fayol, Gulick, Orbic, Max Weber, M.P. Follett. We have already discussed about all these theorists. Taylor is known as father of scientific management theory. Fayol, Gulick, Orbic, classical theorist. Fayol, I have told you, POC plus 14 principle. Gulick, postcard plus 10 principle. Orbic, give 8 principle. Max Weber, theory of bureaucracy. M.P. Follett, she is known as ahead of her time. And she forms a bridge between classical and human relation and behavioral theorist. So all this video already given, so you can watch it in YouTube, all these classes. So today we are going to discuss about Hilton Mayo. Just remember, Hilton Mayo is known as father of human relation theory. Human relation theory is propounded by Hilton Mayo. Clear? And after that, behavioral theorist Bernard Argyris, Likert, MacGregor, Simon, decision making theory, Maslow and Hertzberg, motivational theories, all this known as behavioral theorist. And human relation theory means Hilton Mayo. Remember this. First classical theorists give their theorization, after human relation theories, and after behavioral theorist came. So what is the need of human relation theories and behavioral theorist? Because the classical theorist and their theorization has some flaw. They have certain shortcoming which was being rectified by human relation and behavioral theorists. So whenever you write answer on the classical theorist, Taylor, Fayol, Gulick, Orbic, Weber and Follett, basically Weber. So in their criticism, I have already told you, a question consists of intro, body, conclusion. And conclusion is two part. One is criticism and last is contemporary approach. In the criticism part, you need to criticize the idea of classical theories. Actually, you shouldn't criticize the other. You need to write down that how human relation and behavioral theories criticize the idea of classical theories. You need to write down that. So whenever you write the criticism, just write down that Taylor was criticized by human relation theorist Mayo, behavioral theorist Bernard Argyris, Likert, MacGregor, decision making theorist Simon, and motivational theory Maslow and Hertzberg. So with this, you can write a criticism and contemporary approach. That means Weber's idea is still relevant, Fayol's idea is still relevant, and Taylor's idea is still relevant in 2020. You need to justify how these theories and their idea is relevant. Clear? So again, just look at the chart. I am showing you every day. My aim was to make sure that you remember everything in the class. Woodrow Wilson, father of public administration. Frank would know, father of American public administration. So you don't need to read about Frank Goodnow. Whenever you write Woodrow Wilson, just write down Frank Goodnow. Classical group of theorists, Taylor, Fayol, Gulick, Orbic. Taylor, father of scientific management. Weber, bureaucracy. Yesterday we have discussed about M.P. Follett. She belongs to classical era, but her idea resembles with theorist of human relation and behavioral era. This may ask such a question. So today we will discuss about human relation theorist Hilton Mayo. He is known as father of human relation era. And behavioral theorist MacGregor, Likert, Argyris, Bernard, Simon, decision making, Maslow, Hertzberg, motivation. So this is the syllabus, your syllabus. And today we are going to discuss human relation theorist Mayo. We discuss intro of Mayo, body, conclusion, again divided into two part, criticism, contemporary approach. So mostly Mayo will ask you as a 20 marker question. So you need to write down 200 word. Or Mayo plus Taylor or other theorist acts as a 60 mark question. So we will discuss how we write intro, how we will write intro and what consists the body part, and how we finish with conclusion and contemporary approach. We will discuss that. So this is previous year question. So one question asked, trace out the main tenet of scientific management theory and human relation theory. So you need to write down about Taylor's idea on scientific management and human relation theorist Mayo's idea. I have told you it can be asked as a 60 mark question, but along with other theorists. So Taylor scientific management and Mayo human relation theory critically evaluate their contribution for the development of administrative theory. So just write down their theory and write down that Taylor's idea of scientific management have relevance in the administrative theory and Mayo's idea. You need to write down both this. So I have just make some probable question for you. Mayo has started a different approach than classical theorist. It may be asked as a 20 marker. So same, you write about Mayo. Informal relation in organization is key to success. So Mayo was the first theorist who rejected the formal relation and formal organization being proposed by other classical theorists. And he said that not formal but informal organization and informal relation is also important for the success of any organization. Mayo proved that individual working in an organization is not a machine. That is, Mayo reject machine model of classical theorist. Impact of Hawthorne study on organization. So what is the impact of Hawthorne study on organization? Informal organization, the concept of informal organization, informal relation, human behavior in organization. Okay, just want to give you something. Just focus here, this word, two word, human relation. Human relation. Okay, so we discussed classical theorist, human relation, behavioral theory. So already I have discussed about all these things. Again, repeating, these two words, human and relation. So Ilton Mayo is a theorist who give importance to human relation in organization. So just listen. So Mayo is a theorist who give importance to human relation in organization. So what do you comprehend? These theorists, they never give importance to human relation in organization. So these classical theorists never give due importance to human relation in organization. So it is a criticism. How? So when you write that Taylor or Fayol or Gulick or Bick, Weber, they are criticized by human relation theorist Mayo, your next line is the classical theorists never give due importance to human relation in organization, which was highlighted by Elton Mayo. So it is one criticism you please remember in this classroom. So develop a habit or attitude to write an answer who is concluding criticism. So Taylor was criticized by Elton Mayo because Mayo said Taylor never give due importance to human relation. Who is Mayo give? So you just knowing the character of this theorist, human relation means relation between employee-manager. So this is human relation in organization. So this was being highlighted by Mayo, neglected by all classical theorists. Same behavioral theorists, they focus on human behavior in organization, and it was neglected by these theorists. The classical theorists neglect human behavior in organization, which was promoted by these behavioral theorists. So just try to understand the character of all these theorists. I will discuss it in every class and try my best to make you understand. Character, this is known as character. Character of classical theorists, character of human relation, character of behavioral. So your next criticism is Taylor or other classical theorists, they are criticized by behavioral theorists. On which ground? The classical theorists never give due importance to human behavior in organization. They neglect human behavior, which was being focused by the behavioral theorists. So you can get two criticisms and it is enough for your 20 mark answer. Okay. So this is previous year's question. One question is asked in 2011. So in 2019 or 20 means it is a probable question, Mayo. And these are the four indirect question that may ask in OPSC or UPSC exam. So this is Mayo intro body conclusion. So this is the structural note I have given. With this you can write your answer. You just remember this page. So we will discuss, just want to give you some information. So On Academy started this CPSC GS mock test series under Purushottam Mishra sir, which will help you for your mains preparation. And this is a Delhi T20 GS test series. This is Delhi Current Affairs, which help to build your base. And there are four batch. This is the first batch, Samiksha batch for OCS prelim foundation. And 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Recently a fifth batch launched. So all total 5 batch. So taking admission, taking a plus subscription in On Academy, you can attend every batch, and which will help you to revise multiple times. And it is a course for police examination. And this is ASO Secretariat, 3 batch have launched. Anyone want to prepare for? And this is Delhi G20 test series, every day you please attend, 7:30 to 7:50. And about me, just I have more than 5 year experience and appear in both UPSC and OPSC. And how you study public administration, you must remember the syllabus and understand the interrelation. Read some unit of paper 1, paper 2 together. Before start reading any unit, analyze the previous year question, make structural note for your quick revision. And this is a book I have written. Just go through the book. It covers the whole syllabus. Unitize previous year question. Model answer, 20 long and 40 short, which will help you in your answer writing. And important report of second ARC and first ARC. So just have a look of this book. And I have teaching public administration in On Academy, 90 class. Every class consists of 90 minutes, where we discuss both paper 1 and paper 2 in a comprehensive manner. It is a full course, not a crash course. where we discuss all previous year mains question paper, 150 plus question. Our focus is on answer writing and add current information in our answer. So 16 plus special class are there. You just learn the On Academy Learner app. Follow me there, Deepak Kumar Swami, and you watch this 16 class. If you feel you can get something, you can take a plus subscription and please use this code IDEEPAK10, where you can get a 10% off. And this is the fees for 6 months, 5,000, 3 months, 1 month. And you can again get a 10% discount if you use my code. Okay, this much. Again, Mayo, just give you a brief. Mayo was the first theorist who focused on human and human relation in organization, which was ignored by classical theorist. So it is a criticism to the classicist. He said informal relation and informal behavior between worker is as important as formal behavior, formal relation. He emphasized on socio-psychological behavior of worker, and you need to write about Mayo's publication. What book Mayo has written? If you forget the name of publication of Mayo, just write down. Mayo come out with some important publication which are relevant for the modern day organization. So the invigilator or the examiner evaluator is convinced that you knew about the book Mayo published. So in the body, you write down that Mayo study the workers' behavior in organization. First research program is First Inquiry. Mayo's first research program is named as First Inquiry in Philadelphia. He found that workers are not machine. He studied the physical, psychological, and social behavior of worker. So remember, these things are ignored by classical theorist. The classical theorist focused that human are machine. They never give due importance to the physiological and social behavior of worker in organization. His next study is Hawthorne. Remember, 200 word. Easily you can write. His next study is Hawthorne, 4 phase. First is illumination, which study the impact of light on productivity. Second, relative test room experiment, that study the change in working condition and its impact on productivity. And third is mass interviewing, that the like and dislike of worker. The fourth is bank wiring, that is study group behavior. The group behavior, that means group of employee, their behavior is being studied. Element of human relation theory are individual, informal organization, and participatory management. Individual is being given importance, informal organization, not formal. Organization, formal, informal. Just giving you an example, you are appointed as a BDO. Okay, your driver or your employee, the clerical staff, other staff. Formal relationship means you meet with them in the office, maintain a decorum, that is formal relation. Informal relation, you meet them at lunch, you eat together, you discuss other matter, your family matter, that is informal. So informal organization or informal relation create a bonding between employee. So that is important. And participatory management, that in the management of organization, both employee and manager are participating. It is part of BPSP. I think you have you read in your Indian polity, DPSP, new DPSP, which state that workers should take part in management of organization. And in conclusion, you must write criticism that Mayo's ideal link scientific base. Workers are aware about the study. Mayo ignored work, only focus on worker behavior and the contemporary approaches. Idea is used in modern day organization. IT firm, TCS, Google, Infosys. Okay, now just go in detail. Same thing, I'm reading. Mayo, he is a sociologist by profession, regarded as the father of human relation theory. Human relation theory is a relation criticism, actually it is criticism, criticism to classical approach to organization. The classical thinker stress on formal aspect of organization and neglect human element. Classical theorist neglect human element and focus on mechanistic view of organization and underemphasize the socio-psychological aspect of individual and their behavior in organization. So the classical have mechanistic approach, rigid approach, that was rejected by Mayo, who give importance to psychological, sociological approach. The failure of classical theory gave rise to human relation theory. Very good. Human relation theory is known as humanistic, socio-economic and neoclassical theorist. Mayo concentrated on the study of workers' behavior and production capacity, taking into account the psychological, physical, economic, social and physiological aspect. So Mayo not only give only focus to the environment but also the physical, psychological, economic aspect. He called the approach as clinical method. So what is clinical method? That Mayo's focus to study the organization, the psychology of worker, the economy, the social aspect, the psychological aspect is clinical method. This first research program I have already told at Philadelphia, the first inquiry. Mayo's publication, The Human Problem in an Industrial Civilization. This is Mayo's publication. Mayo said an organization is not a semblance of an individual with their hedonistic interest. Who said this? Classical. The classical theory said that organization is a semblance of individual with their hedonistic. Hedonistic means money. The classical believed that employee join the organization only for money. They have no other concern. Human in organization work to his best possible manner when the urge within him compel him to do the work. Okay, so human in organization work to his best possible manner when the urge, you appointed as a BDO, tahsildar, whatever position, no one can make you work to your best of capacity. Only the urge within you, if you are motivated to work, you will work. Mayo conduct a number of experiments in electric companies Hawthorne. The first is great illumination, relay team assembly, interview, bank wiring experiment. What is illumination? Mayo found that impact of light on productivity. I'm just giving you example. If you people, for example, I am the manager, you people, my student, you are employee. And the classical theorist, if I am a classical manager, I consider you as a machine. You are machine. So now, what is the experiment? What I do? What Mayo do? Mayo increase the light of the room where employee are working and find out the outcome, that what is the productivity? Is it impact on the productivity of worker? After that, Mayo decrease the light. So Mayo found that increase or decrease of light lead to low productivity. So in the room, when I increase the light or decrease the light, you people who are worker, you produce less. So what it implies? That you are not missing. The worker are not missing. If the worker are missing, it will not result into increase or decrease in productivity. So worker are not missing. It was found from great illumination. Listen, these words look heavy, but actually it is not heavy. Very simple thing, great illumination. Light, illumination means light, you just increase or decrease the light to find out that it has impact on your productivity. So it is include that human being are not missing. Relative assembly, in this experiment Mayo found that effect of change in working condition on workers' output and morale. So working condition, for example, you are working in a AC room. I change your room. Now you are working in a room where there is cooler. Third, you are working in a room when there is only fan. And after that, I will make you work in a room where there is no fan. So don't you think due to the heat, your productivity will increase. You will produce maximum in an air conditioned room and you will produce minimum in a room where there is no fan. So it implies that you are human being, you are not machine. Interview, it is to know about the mindset of employee, about their superior, about the ways, the working condition, who worker and other organizational policy. That what employee think about the superior, what is their demand, what is their problem. Fourth is bank wiring. It is to find out the impact of rules on organization output. That the organization's rule, for example, one rule of organization is that you must reach by 9. If you late by 5 minutes, your salary cut. You will get a 20 minute lunch break. So this policy may have an impact on or individual's output. I think you people know about Google. In Google office, there is no work time. You can go anytime, you can come home anytime, you can sleep there, you can eat there. It is like a park. So there is no restriction. When there is no restriction, the motivation among employee will increase. So Mayo found that three type of people exist in organization: rate buster, who produce more, who always work more; chislier, who produce less, the lazy people; and squealer, one who give information to superior about other. So these are jasus people. He always go to the boss and say, sir, Ram is not working, sir, Mohan is doing this, sir, Madan is doing this. So squealer. So every office, whenever you become BDO, tahsildar or any government servant, you will find that these three type of people exist in your organization. So just at that time when you become an officer, just try to find out, remember Mayo, that rate buster was there, chislier are there, and squealer. You need to find out who is what. Next, Mayo's integrative process. Integration means your idea, my idea, if both are mixed, it is integrative process. Individual in an organization produce maximum when you work in a voluntary manner and not in a strict control. So when you work on your own, self-motivation is there, you will produce your maximum. And not like someone is keeping a hunter and threaten you. What my point? Productivity increase when individual have self-control and not superior controlling subordinate. When you have self-control, you control yourself, your productivity automatically increase. We feeling, not I feeling. You must say we, not I. We means you take everyone along with you. The manager must take employee along with him. We feeling of individual is important than I feeling. Mayo applied behavioral science to understand the organization, three element of organization. Mayo found that there are three element of organization. What are they? The individual, just consider you people as a worker. The individual, employee in an organization. Informal organization. Informal means what I discuss, that you meet with other employee in a lunch break. In the canteen, you don't consider that I am an officer, I am a superior, he is a subordinate. No. You mix with them. You talk with them. You discuss their family. You discuss their children's education. So those people give more respect to you. That is informal organization. The classical support formal respect. So less successful. And participative management, involvement of other worker and manager in management of organization. I have told you it is part of DPSP, new DPSP. Worker should associated in management. So this is criticism part. Some theorists criticize the Hawthorne experiment of Mayo by saying that it is not successful. The employee or people knew about the experiment. So answer may be fabricated. The experiment is not scientific. Alex Carey said Hawthorne experiment by Mayo lacks scientific basis. The behavior of worker is not natural. Okay. So it is Alex Carey's criticism. You just need to write. Lawrence said human relation theory is pro-management and anti-union. Ijinoi said human relation theory give much attention to informal organization. Drucker said human relation theory neglect nature of work and only focus on interpersonal relation. Hawthorne experiment is the foundation stone to describe human behavior in organization, the impact of surrounding on workers' productivity. After that, this is contemporary approach. This is Mayo's idea of integrative process, informal organization and participative management help in a great way developing modern organizational theory. So all these are service sector like TCS, Infosys. We found this concept of informal organization, participative management. Okay, so in this way you conclude your answer given some example like TCS, any service sector. So this is for today. Again we will meet next Monday with another class, another theorist, and we will start behavioral theorist MacGregor. So I request you to read from any source the theorist Chester Bernard MacGregor, the behavioral theorist. So in the next week we'll discuss about three behavioral theorists. Okay, so goodbye everyone.